Egghead here couldn't stand traveling with the pack.
Are we all here? Then let's begin. A tunnel. An ancient escape route from the ruins on the island. When I realized it ran all the way across the water, I thought it might prove useful to come and go undetected. So I concealed it from the others. Shall we?
And I wish there was a less pungent way to get way inside the base.
Nigga!
This place smells wrong. No sand or wind, only cold steel. And the others up there, your squad.
They can hold their own. And as for this base, it may not be what you're used to. But it is a shelter.
Call it what it is. A cage.
You came here on your own.
For the battle you promised. So for now I wait in my cage for your word. Tell me when to strike.
The whole time I've been in the West, I've been fighting you and your rebels. I'd at least like to know why.
You were among the enemy. What more is there to know?
Why did you do it?
Dorok, Jiroka, Makalo, and the Karja pushed into the desert to raid our people. My brother's squad was among the first to intercept them. But the Karja captured them, strung them up, and burned them alive as an example. It was too late. I found them by the sound of their screams.
So you wanted vengeance?
Vengeance? No. I wanted devastation. To tear down the Karja's cities and drown the land in blood. Hunt down every last survivor and grind their bones until the sky chokes on the dust. But my chief betrayed me. Betrayed the Tanakh.
How did Hikaru betray
you? Hikaru called on the clans to resist the Karja's red raids. But we did more than just defend. We hunted them. And they fled as children before a pack of claw striders all the way to their border. There we ripped down their stone walls. Their domain was ours for the taking. But when it came time to push on, Hikaru ordered us to fall back. What soldier retreats when slaughter is at hand?
The kind who wants peace for their people.
Peace is just a lull between vendettas. But I thought my chief had greater tactics than mine, so I stood by him even when he allowed that filthy Karja to join our ranks.
Fashav.
I enjoyed watching him die at the embassy. He should have been put down when we first captured him on the field. Instead, Hikaru made him a marshal.
Fashav told me how he became a marshal. He earned it just like any Tanakh.
It was an insult. No outlander can ever deserve to wear our armor, bear our marks. And then a Karja messenger was brought before us? That's when I knew I had to run my blade through Hakaru and drag his treacherous corpse to the gates of the sun.
What happened when the Karja messenger appeared before Hakaru?
The quivering priest bore a message from their new king. No more war. No more raids. Suddenly, the Karja wanted to talk peace. An embassy at the very fortress we tore down? A true Tanakh would never take a Karja truce. Their blood exists to be spilled. But Hakaru lapped up the priest's message. He showed himself a Karja-loving traitor when he accepted. That's when I challenged him.
And lost.
His mercy was just another sign of his weakness. I vowed never to rest until the debt was repaid, with him on his knees before me. So with an army of soldiers and machines at my back, I returned. The day you got in my way.
The deal you made. Override tech in exchange for an assault on the Zenith base. How did Silence approach you?
That name means nothing to me. My agreement was with Oseram mercenaries.
So all this time, you didn't even know who you were really dealing with? And you trusted a group of Outlanders?
If it was a trick, I would have crushed them. But they offered me the chance to run the Karja down with machines. The terror in your enemy's eyes when they see you charge. You know what I'm talking about. I bet you felt it.
I don't think so. What about your end of the deal? Would you have honored it?
Had I killed Hakaru and become chief, these Zeniths would have been the first of the tribe's victories. But because of you, my people will continue to consort with the enemy. A tribe of weaklings.
Because of me, hundreds of Tanakh won't throw away their lives in a battle they can't win. Are you really going to fight alongside me?
I have no reason to betray you.
Really?
I failed to kill Hakaru. Failed to eliminate you. No Tanakh would follow me now. The Karja remain out of my reach, cowering behind their walls. All I have left are the screams of those long dead and unending rage. So show me where to bury.
Are you really going to fight alongside me?
I have no reason to betray you.
Really?
I failed to kill Hakaru. The Karja remain out of my reach. All I have left. So show me where.
All right. I guess we'll both face the end soon enough.
Ever since you got in my way, I've wanted to see your bones burned white beneath the sun. But if I'm to die in battle, then it might as well be with the one who flew with the wings of the Ten.
I'll let you know when it's time to move out.
There you are. Well done, Aloy. Despite my reservations, you managed to secure Silence and his weapon. You're truly a shining example of Liz's fortitude.
I've been thinking about what you said at your house. How you were friends with Elizabeth. It was more than that, wasn't it?
Perceptive as ever. You're right, we were together for a time.
Okay, so What happened?
I was an orphan. I had always been alone. By my 30s, I was starting to wonder if that was simply my fate in life. And then I met Liz. We kept running into each other at conferences. We'd have coffee. At some point, it became drinks. I thought it was just shop talk, an exchange of ideas, but then I was surprised at how much I looked forward to seeing her. Soon we were flying halfway across the world every other week just to meet up. For the first time, I didn't feel lonely. I could imagine a future where I wasn't. I think Liz felt the same way at first. She had lost her mother a few years back. I filled a void for her. I know I did. But as time passed, it seemed as though she wanted less, and I wanted more. And so we ended things.
So helping me, restoring Elizabeth's dream, it's what?
A second chance, yes. I made a mistake leaving Earth while Liz stayed behind. I should have done more. So when I saw you, a woman who has carved her own remarkable path, beyond even what made Liz a phenomenon, I knew I had to help you. To do right by her.
Why do you think Elizabeth pulled away?
I've wondered that for a thousand years. She was brilliant, visionary. She cared so deeply for the world, for the betterment of humanity. But it also felt like she kept everyone at arm's length, including me. She never wanted to share her burdens. I think, in the end, she had a core that she never let anyone be part of. Sometimes I wonder if anyone really knew her.
I found a recording of you and Elizabeth, back in the Proving Lab, after Farzenith's attempt to steal Gaia.
Yes. A most unpleasant conversation.
She said something after the call. I think she regretted how things ended between you.
Did she? All this time, thank you for telling me. I've always hated that those were the last words we ever said to each other. And that her last impression of me was as a functionary of Far Zenith, not who I truly am.
You said before that you're not like the other Zeniths, that you never were. But you went along with all of their plans.
Out of necessity. I'm not proud of it. But complicity became a means of survival, both when Earth was consumed and when the colony on Sirius was destroyed. I did what I had to. But I resolved to remain one step ahead of the others, to try to undo what damage I could. Hence the data channel with Beta. The secret passage into their base and the little trick I pulled to save you.
Why did you make the data channel look like your house?
I built that house as a shelter to weather any storm. A safe place, not just for me, but for the art stored in its depths. Cultural artifacts of incalculable value. Truly, some of the greatest achievements of human civilization.
And you wanted Beta to see them?
Yes. Her upbringing was so cold and technical. I thought if she could experience Vermeer and Rembrandt, it would bring something else into her life. A heritage every bit as valuable as the scientific and technical data being drummed into her. I'm sorry I had to cut off contact, but I'll never regret sharing this house with her. She needed its shelter even more than I did.
When it's time to break into the Zenith base, what can we expect?
I'll go over the full layout once you've assembled your friends. Suffice it to say, we will need to push as fast as possible to Beta and Gaia's location, dealing with heavy resistance along the way. There are also printing facilities where the others have been amassing the natural resources they've stripped from the region.
What for?
First for use in the base's infrastructure, and then to fabricate more Spectre drones, a small army of them.
When I was out in the wilds, I saw a shuttle take off from the island, heading for space.
It was likely ferrying materials to and from our ship in orbit. After hundreds of years luxuriating in our digital comforts, the ship was barely space-worthy when we made our escape. Disaster can strike at any moment. We've learned our lesson.
Have you figured out how Silence's weapon works?
No, and he's been very careful not to allow me near it. I'll admit it bothers me, but regardless of how it functions, I am confident it will deactivate the other shields en masse.
How many of them are in the base?
10, including Eric and Gerard. Only a handful of us made it to our ship when our colony collapsed.
So, Eric, was he always a bloodthirsty psychopath?
I believe he got worse over time. On Earth, he was the founder of a profitable private military company. A band of cutthroats, in other words. Even as governments abandoned human combatants in favor of automated warfare, he found success with clientele that required a more personal touch. There were also rumors that he personally hunted and killed his targets. On occasion, all for the thrill of it. But on Sirius, he retreated to virtual reality simulations. In them, he could go on rampages as violent as he pleased, though I suspect with diminishing satisfaction.
All of his tribe believes he was one of the greatest people from the old world.
Then they would be quite disappointed to meet him, though I'm sure he'd bask in the adoration.
What can you tell me about Gerard?
He was the head of the world's largest financial conglomerate, and as such, had dealings with almost every major corporation. It made him one of the wealthiest people on Earth, and certainly the wealthiest among Far Zenith.
What does one person do with that much money?
Buy more, more power, more influence. Gerard's always believed himself to be a refined patrician, able to maintain control with a polished smile. But beneath that exterior is a cold and calculating operator. It was his decision to restrict Beta's upbringing to her digital educators, the avatars of the Apollo database, while we were painted as her benefactors.
Well, we'll deal with him soon enough, and the others.
I would very much like to see his face when he realizes we've beaten him.
When I was in the ruins of Vegas, I found data on a man named Stanley Chen. I think he was a Zenith.
Stanley, ever the optimist. He was one of the good ones. When we established our colony, he built an exact replica of Las Vegas in virtual reality. Lights, shows, gambling, every detail perfectly recreated. And while others cloistered themselves in their own fantasies, he flung his doors wide to everyone.
The way you're talking about him, I'm guessing he didn't make it back to Earth?
No, he perished when our colony was destroyed. He would have been thrilled to discover that part of his beloved city survived.
When Beta escaped and hid in an ancient research facility, I saw another one of the Zeniths. For Baina. Who was she?
A dull star amidst a sea of brighter constellations. Unlike most of Far Zenith's members who amassed their wealth through shrewd business deals and technological achievements, Verbena inherited her billions. Her father had achieved great success in the luxury holotourism industry. At age 24, she became the world's most eligible bachelorette. branding herself a life designer. Someone who leverages their fame to influence the choice of others.
What? Like a cult?
In a way, yes.
Well, she must have done something right to have survived this long.
She was her own brand of ruthless. That much is true. But even rats can cling to a vessel for escape.
Okay, so I've had run-ins with a handful of Zeniths. What about the rest?
An array of the wealthiest people on Earth. Titans of their industries.
And let me guess, all selfish and ruthless to the core?
Most, but not all. There were a few with whom I got along. Annika Merzhani, for instance, was always delightful. She founded the Holonet's most successful dance channel and was herself mesmerizing to watch. And I had fascinating discussions with Song Zhao about her work in cellular biology. Our immortality treatments are due in part to her achievements. But then there were others like Devin Miller, the CEO of a fast food printing corporation. His only real preoccupations were perfecting his golf swing and taking self-hollows. When I think about all of us, we really should have accomplished more. We had eternity.
Okay. I'll let you know when it's time.
I'll be here until then. And thank you, Aloy, for giving me this chance. My past has always been a struggle. More than once, I've lost everything. But when I look to the future, I see Liz's dream fulfilled. A universe of new possibilities.
Maybe we can make it happen.
We will. I won't let anything get in the way. I promise you that.
I see you've got your new arm ready to go.
Yes. It still feels strange. I've gotten used to the absence, but no matter. I'm sure I will need it before the attack on the Zenith base is through.
So, our enemy is immortal. Most of my people don't survive past 30.
Haven't seen you since the battle at the Grove. How are you holding up?
I saw you fly on the wings of the Ten, and paralyze Regala's army with lightning. I would say that I am inspired.
Thank you, I guess.
It is I who should be thanking you.
Look, I know you're probably not happy about keeping Regala around, but I want her on our side when we fight the Zeniths.
It is more than she deserves. Even so, I will not question your judgment.
Thank you, Catalo. Things will get ugly once the Zeniths realize we're in their base. You'll need every trick you've ever learned.
I would have it no other way. Many soldiers died in the old world to make sure we stood here today. We will endure on their behalf. Though, I am curious how you intend to defeat the Zeniths' defenses without an army of our own.
Leave that to me. Just make sure you're ready to fight.
As you say. You have more than earned my trust.
Did you meet Tilda?
There is something about her that doesn't seem natural. I wouldn't be surprised if my sword went through her and she didn't bleed at all.
Honestly, with her, nothing would surprise me. Your people keep mentioning the wings of the Ten. What exactly does it mean?
The visions tell us that the Ten flew on great metal machines with wings and leapt into battle from the sky. For us, to imitate this feat is the ultimate expression of martial prowess. It is why the challengers leap into the arena during the Kulrit
And now, you have done it. Like the deeds of the Ten themselves, it will never be forgotten. So, tell me, how did it feel?
I won't lie. Pretty good.
I can only imagine.
I have to go. But I'll be briefing everyone on the plan soon.
Understood.
Huh. There's Quen stuff in here now. Must be all of us.
You flew? Kotalo told me. And took out Regala's machines? You know what? I don't even know why I'm surprised. I saw we have visitors and a new weapon. Does this mean we're ready to take the fight to the Zeniths?
Almost. Are you okay?
I was wondering, is it really safe having someone like Regala here? She seems angry. The kind of angry that leads to murdering people in their sleep.
Don't worry. We're going to point that anger in the right direction. The Zeniths.
If you say so.
I hope our new guests have been behaving.
The Silence. He's the one who built the weapon that can take down Zenith shields?
He is. Though I wouldn't expect him to answer any questions about it. He refuses to dole out his secrets to us, lesser mortals.
Oh.
You know that special part of us that makes us warm, kind, welcoming?
Our spirit?
Yeah. He was born without that. You sure you're okay going on this mission? I know things must be happening pretty fast for you.
Already braved oceans and madmen who thought they were ancestors reborn. Why not a few immortals with lethal drones at their command, too?
Guess the more the merrier. I suppose you saw that Tilda is here. Our very own Zenith.
I almost went up to her to ask her, well, every question I've ever had about the legacy. Every diviner I know would kill to get 5 minutes with one of the old ones. But now that she's here, all I feel is a vague unease. I don't know if I'm scared of finding out more uncomfortable truths, or just scared of her. Probably both.
I need to wrap up a few things, but stay sharp.
I'll be ready when you call.
Did you need something? Bravo. You managed to sway a Zenith to your side. Care to explain?
Not a chance. I thought you said the weapon was ready.
There's always room to optimize. But that's not why you're here. I assume you want to comprehend my undertakings. So, ask away.
Since when were you so forthcoming?
Since you turned this into a waiting game. And as it seems, you have found modest success. Perhaps I'm willing to be generous.
Okay, so your big plan, everything you've been manipulating for the last few months. Let me see if I got this straight. You learned about the Zenith from Hades when you interrogated it. Then you came up with a plan to defeat them by using a Tanakh army and that weapon. And to get the Tanakh to fight for you, you, or rather the sons of Prometheus, armed Regala's rebels with override tech.
Did you have an actual question, or are you still playing catch-up?
So all this time, even before I found the coordinates at the Spire, you were out here scheming. Why couldn't you just tell me?
When I learned of the Zenith's return to Earth, I laid out my plans. I knew I would one day require an army of overzealous Tanakh to assault the Zenith base. The casualties would be extreme. And I knew you would never allow such a sacrifice, no matter how necessary. Thus, I devised a means to remove your interference from the equation at the Hades Proving Lab.
You wanted me to surrender to the Zenith at the Hades Proving Lab. They almost killed me.
Based on everything I knew about them, I concluded they would find you a useful asset, thereby keeping you out of harm's way and, more importantly, out of my way.
So you really didn't know they had their own clone of Elizabeth?
No. Unfortunately, there was no way I could have known that particular detail.
Detail? Well, I guess if it wasn't for that, we wouldn't be here today. Why create the Sons of Prometheus? You didn't need a bunch of Oseram tinkerers to make override tech.
They were a necessary safeguard. My time serving Hades in the Eclipse demonstrated the risks of getting directly involved. Through the Sons of Prometheus, I could execute my plans, all while remaining anonymous.
Why help Regala take over? If you wanted an army, you could have just gone to Hikaru.
Before Regala's rebellion, Hikaru was only concerned with battling machines and fostering friendships with Akarja. Even if I gained his ear, he would never agree to send his forces to battle a threat he couldn't understand.
So helping a bloodthirsty exile was easier?
Yes. Exceedingly so. All Regala craved was war against the Akarja and anyone who threatens the Tanakh. She would have led the tribe into battle without question, which was precisely what I needed.
Tell me about the weapon. How does it work?
I've upgraded the delivery system. It now emits a wave-like effect covering a significant distance.
That doesn't fully answer my question.
No, but I'd be a fool to reveal its inner workings. After all, why did you withhold your plan for dealing with the Zenith drones? Yes. Even you can appreciate the value of secrecy when warranted. Suffice it to say that the weapon will work. The intricacies of how is knowledge that is mine alone.
While I was out there, I had a couple run-ins with the Quen.
The tribe from across the ocean. And?
Their entire tribe was shaped around the discovery of focuses. One of them, Alva, even joined me here. Don't you want to know more about them?
No. They stumbled upon the greatest technological artifact from the ancient world, and what did they do with it? They shrouded the knowledge they unearthed in mysticism and taboo, creating a pantheon out of corporate shields.
Yes, well, it also led them to Thebes.
Did it now?
So those run-ins with the Quen I mentioned. On one of them, I teamed up with their expedition to search Thebes. We found Pharaoh at the end.
You must have needed Omega clearance. So, what was it like?
Worse than you can imagine.
He single-handedly wiped out collective human knowledge. I'm sure it was still less than he deserved.
Let me guess. You would have scraped him into a jar so you could prod his brain, like what you did with Hades.
For a start.
All right, Silence, I think I've talked to you long enough. I'll let you know when it's time to go. And try not to mess with Tilda while you're in here, okay? I don't need the two of you butting heads.
Yes. About your Zenith ally. I wonder if you understand what kind of person you're dealing with. For someone to live as long as she has, outlast as many calamities, well, your goals may be aligned now, but I'd watch for the moment they diverge.
Yeah, I'm aware. Reminds me of someone else I know.
Survival is only a necessity to my greater purpose, Aloy. I'd hoped you'd recognize that by now.
Do you know something or not?
Oh, I know a great deal of things. But on this, just call it a feeling.
Oh, a feeling? You mean you finally had one? Huh. Guess even you can change, Silence. Okay, maybe it's time to get everyone together so Tilda can brief us. But is there anything I should handle before that? Okay, data module's in.
So, you return.
All right, people. I need you up in the control room, right away. Okay, everyone. We all know what's at stake. Beta, Gaia. Not to mention life on Earth. Now, it might seem like the Zeniths are invincible, but they're not. We've got what it takes to break into their base and defeat them. We even have one of them on our side. Tilda, show us the base.
It is constructed atop the ruins of an ancient military facility on an island to the southwest. I can get us inside, to this location, undetected.
How exactly?
You'll know when you need to. Once inside, our goal will be this structure. The launch tower. Gaia and Beta are being held at the top. But along the way, we will face overwhelming resistance. Most importantly, from Gerard, Eric, and the others. But also...
Once I take away their shields, we should be able to deal with them. But it will be easier to deploy the device if someone else is carrying it. I'll need a strong back.
Carry stuff? Yeah, I can do that.
Even if your device works, there will still be Spectre drones, scores of them.
If only we had an army to fight them.
I've got that under control. You'll know when you need to. All right. We'll meet up again just before we go in. Where's the best place to rendezvous?
On the coast, just across from the island. Once there, I'll show you the way.
Okay. I'll let you know when I arrive at the rendezvous point. And then you can join me. In the meantime, do whatever you need to prepare. Understood? You two? A minute? Tilda helped me get in touch with Beta, and she told me something important. There's an installation inside the base. It's called a regulator. Here. Once we're inside, I need you two to split off from everyone else and destroy it. So you'll have to bring explosives. This will help stop the drones. Everything depends on it. Are you with me? After that, I want you to find a way to infiltrate the Zenith network.
How?
Go over all the data that Beta left behind. She knew how to do it, I'm sure of that.
All right. But why? What am I trying to do?
Find information about Zenith. Anything Tilda's not telling us. Sans is right about one thing. There's no way we can take her on her word.
I'll do my best.
Keep her safe, okay?
On my life.
We're finally doing this.
Never thought I'd be off on a mission to take down a bunch of immortals from the stars. I can hear the drinking songs already.
Farrell made the right call, you know, bringing you here.
Thanks. Yeah, Varl. You know, I never knew he had a sister. I found out a few days before you guys went to Gemini. I was, well, to be honest, I was terrified I'd screw up the mission somehow. So he sat me down for a drink, just one, mind you. And we talked about family. Vala, Ursa, loss and revenge. How you helped us.
You know, we never did get that drink you promised back in the Embrace. And you never told me exactly how your sister escaped the Mad Sun King.
I guess we never got round to it. World ending and all. No time like the present, though. If you're up for it.
You think it's time for us to finally have that drink?
Yeah. I mean, yeah, of course. Oh.
So, how did Ursa escape Mad Sun King Dron's palace?
Well, first she had to survive the Sun Ring. See, during the war, the Karja threw a prisoner a day in there. And, you know, for what? To die as sacrifices, fighting machines in a pit. Thinking somehow that was gonna appease all the other deranged machines in the world? Ha! And when it was Ursa's turn, the Karja thought she'd go down if they threw a big machine at her.
Oh, but she didn't.
And she defeated all of them. Even got some of Jiran's kestrels for good measure. And the Mad Sun King was impressed, I guess. Thought it'd be funny to have her run around his palace as a servant. He enjoyed humiliating her that way.
I remember you telling me something about that. That's how she met Avad. He helped her escape.
Yeah, but what no Karja scroll will ever tell you is how the young prince snuck Ersa out of the palace. He knew their best chance was to get Ersa to blend in, so he got her everything she needed to disguise herself as a Karja noblewoman. Yeah, perfumes, veils, and all.
I get the feeling she wasn't too happy with that.
Oh, man. Ersa would have rather fought her way out of that palace with her bare hands than put on all of that Karja eye paint. But Avad insisted it was the only way, so she agreed under one condition. Avad had to dress up as well.
She made Avad dress up like a noblewoman?
As perfumed and powdered as a babe. Ursa said he looked better like that than he ever did in a crown.
That would definitely make for an interesting sight.
Oh, it worked like a charm, too. Not only did they make it out of the palace, they paid a traveling merchant to get Ursa to the border, and none were the wiser.
You were right. That was a story best told over a drink.
All good stories are.
If that one's not working right, you can have one of my spare focuses, you know.
Yeah, little bugger's got some personality, that's all. Save my butt with those spectres. Wouldn't feel right to leave it behind now. You know, besides, it goes with my outfit.
Wouldn't want to spoil your look. I guess I should get going.
I'll see you at the rendezvous point. With my hammer ready.
I wouldn't have it any other way. I hope everybody's ready for this. Fighting the Zeniths isn't going to be easy.
Aloy, nothing you do ever is. At least, now you don't have to do it alone.
Thanks. You and Aaron seem to be on better terms now.
He may have terrible taste in music, but he did apologize for mocking my tribe. And that ale he keeps raving about isn't half bad. I still plan on beating that stubborn face of his to break our sparring stalemate.
Try not to hurt him too bad. Everyone here, training, working together. If it weren't for Varl, none of it would have happened.
You know, there was this one night, right before Varl left with you to go to Gemini. He realized I was having trouble sleeping. I was nervous about the mission. To be honest, I think we both were. So he asked me to join him in Gaia's dome. He brought up this hologram of Earth that you two found back in the Zenith launch facility. We sat there, just looking at it. I thought about how Plainsong was just a speck on that great sphere. How every corner of it must be teeming with life. And any fears I had about our mission were gone. I miss him terribly.
I know. I should go. I'll let you know when I'm ready to head to the base.
Before you do, there is one favor I would ask of you.
What is it?
You placed this focus in my care and gave me the highest calling an Utaru has ever known. If I should fall in battle, I'd like you to be the one to bury my seed pouch. For the both of us.
So,
make sure you stay alive to do so.
Let's just try to all come back home. Okay? You nervous?
I'd be lying if I said I'm not slightly apprehensive.
The plan will work if we all focus on our assignments.
Right.
I want you to know I'm glad you're with us, Alva.
Whatever happens, I'm grateful that the legacy brought us together. I never thought I'd get to actually meet an ancestor.
Come on, do I look that old? Katala will protect you inside the Zenith base.
I'm not afraid. I know Katala will fulfill his duty, as will I. If we die doing so, at least it'll be alongside a friend.
I'd rather you both stay alive, if you don't mind.
We'll try and keep that in mind.
Once all this is over, will you go back across the ocean?
I don't know. The more I think about it, the more worried I become. If I go back, I don't even know if they'd let me keep this focus you gave me. Or what they'd do to me for reading what is clearly forbidden data. Even if I somehow were allowed to carry on my duties as a diviner, would I be willing to let the truths I've learned about the ancestors be buried away by the Board of Overseers? Would I dare challenge them and risk my family's safety? Or losing Federa?
Who's this Federa you mentioned?
She is another diviner. One of our best. We used to be rivals at the Academy. I hated her guts. But apparently there's a fine line between hate and love. We became very close, and then I was assigned to the expedition. She promised she'd wait for me, no matter how long it took.
Well, that was smart of her. She won't do any better.
Yeah, I don't know about that.
I do. The rest of us should be enough of a distraction to the Zeniths for you to hack into their network undetected. But you'll have to be quick, in case they do.
What exactly do you expect me to find, Aloy?
I don't know. The truth, if we're lucky. I need to get going.
I'll be at the rendezvous point. May truth lead us to victory.
Aloy. Something else?
I'll be going.
As you wish.
What now?
That's all for now.
Leave, then. Welcome back, Aloy. Would you like to continue our chat?
I should be going.
I'll be making final preparations.
So, how are we feeling about the mission?
I do not know everything that you have planned, but it doesn't matter. All that remains is to follow you to the end, whatever that will be.
Thank you, Katala. I'm glad all this brought us together.
You brought us together, and I am grateful too. Oh, and by the way, I was hoping now would be a good time to go back to the Tremortusk site and test my new arm before we leave on our mission.
Right. I'll let you know when I can make my way there.
Thank you.
We didn't really get to talk about what happened at Gemini.
There was nothing more to say. If he were to Nacht, Varl's bravery would have earned him sacred burial at the Grove, among the most distinguished of our tribe's warriors. His deeds were worthy of the Ten. When the fight is done, I will have the Inkers etch his memory on my skin, so that it may live on.
I'm sure he'd be honored. Now that training time is over, what's on your mind?
The Bulwark, the Kulrut, and how we need another miracle if we're to survive the Zenith base.
I'll try not to let you down.
I know you will not.
I'll see you soon, then.
It will be my honor.
Well, now I know where metal flowers come from. Last-ditch effort to stop the Pharaoh Plague. Must have started distributing them after it took refuge in the greenhouse. Okay, everyone. I'm at the rendezvous point. It's time to rescue Beta and Gaia.
Understood, Aloy. We're on our way.
Aloy.
Where are the others?
Not far behind.
Egghead here couldn't stand traveling with the pack.
Are we all here? Then let's begin.
A tunnel. An ancient escape route. From the ruins on the island. When I realized it ran all the way across the water, I thought it might prove useful to come and go undetected. So I concealed it from the others. Shall we?
I wish there was a less pungent way to get way inside the base.
Agreed.